Hello friend, welcome you all. So today we are going to discuss about the linear bounded automata. The name itself says it is a bounded automata. So first of all, going to further, I just want to show some a diagram, which is very important diagram. I also discussed the diagram in my previous videos. So if you don't watch that video, then please go to that video, then you have a good understanding at this level. So for a particular in TOC, there are the term is known as a grammar, and the term is known as a language, and the thing is simply known as a, you can say, automata. So it is a classification. So we know that there is a four types of grammar. You can say type 0, type 1, type 2, and type 3. So it is a lower level, is simply known as a type 3 grammar, which is simply known as a regular grammar, and the grammar generates the language, which is simply known as a regular language. And this regular language is accepted by or rejected by the automata, is simply known as a finite automata. We discuss all that things. In the upper part, there is a next, we can say, grammar, which is simply known as a type 2 grammar. The type 2 grammar generates and language is simply known as a context free language. We already discussed what is a context free language and what is the grammar form of it. You can watch in a previous video. And the simply automata which accept or reject the particular language is context-free language or not, it's simply known as a push-down automata. After then, we can say, today we are going to discuss linear bounded automata, or we can say LBA. So we simply take a part of introductory part of linear bounded automata. After it, we will discuss grammar of it, and the language which is generated by this grammar is simply known as a context sensitive grammar. So it is a type 1, we can say, grammar. And the topmost is simply known as the unrestricted grammar, and the language which is generated by this grammar is known as the unrestricted language. And we can say this unrestricted language is accepted by the machine, is simply known as a Turing machine. So we discuss a Turing machine, we will discuss a grammar and all the rest of part. It is very important classification. I hope you know the all this classification and different level according to the grammar, which is corresponding language and which is corresponding automata. So now today we are going to discuss about the linear bounded automata, or we can say linear bounded automata. What is a linear bounded automata? What is the definition of it? We have just introductory look on it. So a Turing machine that uses only the tape space occupied by the input is called the linear bounded automata. See, the name itself contained the bounded. Bounded, it means, see, the Turing machine, tape inside the Turing machine is not a bounded. It's not bounded. It means the left side, the tape left side is infinity and the right side is also infinity. So there is an infinity tape side. But here we are simply bounding in the linear manner, and the automata is bounded in the linear manner, then simply is known as a linear bounded automata. But now thing is that what the condition we use to bound that particular automata, bound it means was the size we limit a tape size, on which basis the tape size we will limit. So on the basis of the input, if the tape size will be the equivalent to the input size, then it is simply known as a linear bounded automata. I hope you understand. For an example, if the input size is 5, then the tape size will be 5. And the input size is 10, the tape size will be 10, and so on. So if we bound a tape size according to the input, then that Turing machine is simply known as a linear bounded automata. I hope you watch my previous video in which we make so many modifications in the Turing machine. We also use a bounded Turing machine, which we bound the left side or right side and something like that. Another definition, very simple definition, it is a non-deterministic Turing machine. See, the linear bounded automata is a non-deterministic. What is a non-deterministic? Non-deterministic, it means for a particular input, there is a more than one derivation. One derivation, it means more than one move. If at a particular state we have one input, then we get more than one output or more than one movement, then simply known as a non-deterministic. So it is a non-deterministic Turing machine in which the tape size is equal to the input. So what is the size of tape? I already told you, if the input tape size is equivalent to the input size, then simply it is known as a linear bounded automata. The linear bounded automata is more powerful than the push down automata, definitely. the push down automata having the less power as compared to the linear bounded automata. Now the tape is bounded, already I told you. Uses two symbol shows the ending the tape. It means if the bounded tape is bounded, then we use the two types of symbols which shows that the when the read write had reached to the particular this two symbol, then the input will end. So it means we use any symbol, but I took some of my reference. I simply took we can say dollar for the left end, and I can say C cross for the right end. The language accepted by the linear bounded automata is known as a context sensitive language. Already we discussed in the previous slide, and the generated by the context sensitive grammar. So this context sensitive language is simply generated by the context sensitive grammar, and the particular language accepted by or not is simply known by the linear bounded automata. So now there is a standard definition of it. So it is a nine tuple variable. So where are we simply introduce the two new things, which is the left end and the right end. You can use LM, light, right limiter, left limiter, your left end, your right end, any symbol you can use. It's simply showing if it is in mandatory to show that the tape is bounded. For that, we are using the two symbols. So there are some tuples. We know that so many tuples are compulsory, so many are repeated, so many times we seen these particular things. So Q is a finite set of state. The number of state which included in the particular linear bounded automata is represented by the Q, capital Q. It is input alphabet or symbol. Suppose there is a combination of A and B, suppose A, A, B, B, or 0, 0, 1, 1, then we can say input alphabet A, B, or 0, 1. So the particular symbol are used to generate a string, it's simply known as an input alphabet or symbol. I think you know that. The toy tap of the alphabet, it means simply say the tape contain the input value, it's simply known as a toy. So the input string combination generate a particular string which is put on the particular tape. It is a transaction function. So already I told you that Turing machine linear bounded automata is simply nothing but non-deterministic Turing machine with the tape size is equivalent to the input. So it is a non-deterministic, that's why the Turing function transaction function in the non-deterministic Turing function will be, there is an input state, there is a particular state and input symbol, then we can move 2 to the power of any input any state, then any tape variable, then we are moving to the left and right. So it is simply a transaction function of a linear bounded automata. Then Q node, it simply shows that is an initial state. B, it's simply a blank. One more thing, some of the students having the confusion that why we use a blank. It may be possible that we need required to replace a particular input symbol with a blank. So B, blank is simply represent there is a nothing, any input string, but it not represent the end of particular tape. So end is represented only by the dollar and the C cross. So F is a set of final state. Maybe there are some one final state or more than one final state, that is simply represented by the capital F. And dollar, it simply means the left hand symbol, and the C cross simply represented by the right hand symbol. So here is simply a diagram which simply shows that what is a finite automata modified, which is represented as a linear bounded automata. So it is a tape. So the in between size is equivalent to the input size, and the left hand is stopped by the dollar, and the right hand is stopped by the C cross. So inside there is an input which is fixed size according to the length of the input. Then when this read write head moves to the left side and read the dollar, it means now the tape is end. And when it goes to the right side and find the C cross, it means it conclude that the tape is end over here. So I hope you understand this basic concept of linear bounded automata. There is one important thing you have to be noted down, that if any non-deterministic Turing machine tape size is equivalent to the particular input, then it is known as a linear bounded automata. That is the one point. And another point is, a tape is always indicated by two indicators, or we can say two endpoints, which is a left endpoints and right endpoints. We use any symbol for representing the endpoints, so it is important. So it is simply introduction part of linear bounded automata. In the upcoming videos, we are going to discuss some detail about on it. I hope you understand this explanation. I try to my best to explain you these things. So I feel very happy if you ask me any question if you have any doubt on this particular explanation. So thank you very much.